So we went, I mean, we went crazy after this material. So we, you know, this was so inspiring. We dug into deep, a lot of ways to make it. And this was costly. This was like $50 to $500 a gram, almost like drugs. And this was like pretty expensive for us to buy in our college days. So we said, let's re-engineer and can we do it on our own way? So we researched papers, articles, you know, nights after nights we spent just digging, can we make it ourselves? And then, you know, and then common sense struck. I mean, to make carbon, you need carbon. You cannot make carbon out of oxygen. So from story one, there was a lot of carbon, free carbon that you don't want, the carbon dioxide, methane coming out. And then you want to make carbon nanotubes. So we thought if you can do this, connect this thing, it's going to be magical. So that's what we started working on. I mean, we don't have, we just have one picture here. I mean, started working on the ground temperatures. I mean, he's the one who spends like 8 hours and like 600 degrees to 800 degrees, you know, changing samples. I mean, so we spent almost one and a half years, countless numbers of failure experiments before getting something good. I mean, so we tested, re-engineered, and finally we got something black. We call this our black gold. If you look closely, these are the carbon nanotubes and carbon nanofibers. So we have, we commonly call them as carbon nanostructures because the compositions vary from where we actually get it. But this was a eureka moment. I mean, we did run around, not naked, but we did run around counting this. The bigger picture, what Daniel was talking about is, now we have made it profitable sequestering carbon. I mean, now you can convert the pollution that comes out of industry into something useful. Reducing is not a solution because the rate at which industries are going, you cannot reduce that. So you have to make it the waste into something useful. And that's where our science is. Why are we going to be profitable, successful? Because there are three things about us. We are low cost. Our production cost is less than half a dollar. I mean, not counting our own salaries and stuff, but it's almost less than half a dollar as compared to $20-$50 or so. We are eco-friendly. We are high quality. I mean, if you look at the applications of carbon fibers, Boeing 787, it's 50% by weight is carbon composites, I mean, which is huge. I mean, so what we are making is something not that is absolutely new and we need to create demand. It's in use. We're just making it eco-friendly and at low cost. Other applications, body armors, flexible phones, space elevators. I mean, riding with a girlfriend to the moon would be amazing. Give credit to us someday if we can scale it up. And stuff like, you know, rubber composites, stuff like where you have tennis rackets, cement bricks, construction. There are a lot of ways you can use this. How do we make money on this? First, we charge a license fee from the companies where we reduce the carbon emissions because, I mean, a lot of companies have no way in India to reduce them. And our equipment is pretty easy to install in any of the chimneys that they have. When the emissions come out, we just go and install it, and it just drastically cuts down the emissions. The second is, once we start production, we sell the material that we make to composite manufacturers, to research labs, and they can, you know, build on equipments that I told you about in the future. So that is the second source of revenue. But both of these are like the smaller sections of revenue for us. The biggest section, and that's the future that we look into, is making the composites ourselves. There is no point making low-cost material and selling it to somebody who makes a profit out of your own science. So this is where we are focusing now. Since we have a good lock-in on the technology of making nanotubes, we want to scale up making composites out of it. I mean, and that is where we need a lot of expertise to come in. This is how we framed up. I mean, we started off in 2010, early 2011. We did the testing and verification. I mean, our process has been verified by the government of India. We optimized it for different industries. So we can work with any carbon emitting industry, and we can make them into carbon nanotubes and fibers. 2013 is where we're going to go large scale. This is the market size for just selling the nanostructures as of now. And all analysts and, you know, big research reports which are available for like $10,000 in the market, which we don't buy, they say like 20% growth rate is there. But with the price that we are going to offer it, we want to see a disruptive growth in the market. So, and we want to have like 20% of this market in probably 5 years of time as we go through. We were the first Indian nanotechnology company to be covered in Forbes 30 and the 30. We are covered in MIT Technology Review, Ashoka Staples Entrepreneurship Award, the Government of India, National Research Development Corporation of India. Yes, we like to win prizes, but we are young people, we love that. We need, yes, so you love the technology, but love is not enough. You need money over a two-year time frame, around $800,000 to hire more people who are more engineers than scientists. I mean, we can call ourselves scientists. We need people who are engineers who can fabricate large-scale industries to make composites as we wanted. 20 seconds is a tough thing for us to speak, so we just give me our email ID, we'll be available. We want to talk more. I mean, Japan is technologically so advanced, it would be great to dive here, and that should be it. Thank you.